Good afternoon, Wilkie fans. Hey, this is Brian over at Wilkie Manufacturing. Today I'm doing a video. This is a Ford F-550, and there's currently a recall notice that a lot of people that had previously got our equipment are getting, and I just kind of wanted to explain why this really will not affect you, other than they will request that they do a visual inspection on this area right here on the Ford F-550s. If you're looking, you'll notice that this frame widens out and then tapers down to go underneath the cab. And you'll also notice that there's a fitment weld here where it goes from a boxed frame to a channel frame. And you can see a little better there of where they did the weldment and it came through. Now, the other thing you'll notice is there's some plates here on the top side. What that is that when you mount a bed on here, you have all the rivets here on the top side. Without this fitment plate, then your top side of your bed will rub on these rivets and eventually cause a failure in this area. But all Wilkie equipment has these fitment plates on here to act as a spacer to give you clearance for the rivets. You can see that there. But I'm going to move over here to this other bed, and I'll show you one that's mounted up to kind of explain a little bit more on how we build our beds to make sure that you have a long life and durability on your equipment. Now you'll notice on this is a Wilkie Model 52 XLR. It's on a F-550. And you'll notice that we built the equipment with the base behind the rear axle with the rear set of down outriggers. The reason for this is that when you're working over the front of the piece of equipment or off to the sides, you're compressing all of the suspension on the truck. Not just the rear suspension or not just the front suspension. The rear stabilizers, when you're working off the back, your weight of the truck acts as a counterbalance and it gives you the side-to-side stability that you need for your equipment. The other thing that you'll notice is that we mount our beds on, we encapsulate the rear end. This is all boxed in. And this works as a torsion box, and we do this on all of our equipment. And you can see some of the spacer plates that I showed earlier here. We tie through the frame. This one goes through here, but you'll also notice that in areas that you need movement for road torsional twist, we encapsulate the frame here with a full tie down. These tie down bolts here are a stress proof shafting that we make in-house. This is a little tight, but you can see the area of fitment here. Now you'll notice that if you're looking up, this tubing, our main stringer is tubing. It is a rectangle tube, it's a 2x8 heavy duty tube, and you can see we encapsulated the frame through a cut through here. This brings all your stress that would normally be associated here towards the rear of the truck back into a more solid area. This is the other reason that we do not do a forward mounted base. The reverse, what they would call a reverse mount, where your base would be mounted in this area and then the tube package would be facing off to the back. If you're doing that, you need to really inspect this area here for cracking. Thing is that when you reverse mount, you're putting a lot more stress in this area of the piece of equipment as opposed to over the back where load carrying capacity is designed in. I hope this is explanatory, and If you have any questions, please feel free to give me, Brian, or my brother Daryl, or my brother Bruce, a call here at Wilkie Manufacturing. Have a great day, and thanks for watching. Please subscribe and like.